static members concept. So with that, I'll be proceeding to the next important concept of any object-oriented programming language. That concept is called as inheritance concept. Suppose, let me give you one simple example. How this inheritance concept becomes useful when you are in the software industry. Okay. Say, for example, your father, a single father has two boys. Okay, college-going boys are there. Two boys are there. Each of these boys, okay, if suppose father gets a bike, each of them will demand for a separate bike. Okay. So he has to put investment on two bikes. One for the first son, second one for the second son. Okay. So instead, he needs a lot of money to invest on two bikes. Instead, if he suppose invests on a single bike and he keeps that bike with him, okay, in his house, then all the members of the house will be in a position to share that particular bike whenever they want. Okay, when the first boy is not, now both the sons, okay, because that's the property of the father and there is only one bike, both the sons have the right to access the bike at different intervals of time. When son one is using the bike, son two is not using. When son two is using the bike, son one is not using. So you can avoid, you can avoid this repetition of investment on two separate bikes. Okay, if the bike is with your father, if he invests on one single, instead of giving two separate bikes to two different sons, if he invests on a single bike and he keeps that bike with him, okay, each of these sons will be in a position to access that bike whenever they want. So this repetition of purchasing can be avoided. So now let us try to apply this, okay, to coding concept. Say, assume I have, say for example, let me open a blank notepad. Say now, if suppose you have a method, for example, say show. Assume there is a show method. If you are writing show method, okay, in two separate classes. Say this is son one. Son one is one class. Let us assume this is son one. And this is like bike. Son one has bike. Son two also has bike. Bikes are same model. Let us assume same model bikes are there with both of them. Because the other one will start questioning. If show method we are writing here and here, it results in repetition of code. See, the same code is getting repeated at two points. Okay, this is son two. Instead, okay, this causes redundancy of code. Okay, this can be avoided by trying to have, instead of giving a separate bike to every son, what the father can do is, the father, okay, let us assume the father's name is, say, father, he will keep the bike with himself. Father, this is father F, okay. Or I will call him as father only. My handwriting is not this bad because I am using this board, digital board. You find my difficult as so awkward. Please bear that my handwriting is not this bad. It is bad, but it is not this bad. Okay, so now, instead of writing code for show in two different functions, in two different classes, what I am trying to do is I am trying to write this in a single class, and for this class I create two children. Okay, I create two children. Son one is first child, son two is second child. Okay, so these are classes. I am creating two subclasses for the class father. First one is called as son one, second one is called as son two. How many times I am writing this code? I am trying to write this code instead of writing show here and here separately. I wrote show completely in a different entity, which I called as father, and I made these two entities, son one and son two, the derived two entities called as son one and son two. I made them the children. Let us assume how these are made the children. Let us see it later. I am making son one and son two as the children of a father called as father. So now both of them being the children, they'll have all rights to access the properties of the father. Okay, so the children, definitely all the children of that father can access this code. Okay, both of them will be able to access the code. So without rewriting this code in each of these blocks, that results in repetition of code. What I made is I used this code only in one entity, and I created two children called as son one and son two. And now, because these two are the children, they have the right to access the properties of the father. So what is the property of the father? Show is now the property. So both son one and son two will be able to access this particular code. So how many times I am writing this code? I am writing this code only once. Still I am able to access that particular code from both of these children. I am able to access this code that is written only once. So this concept of creating a new entity, okay, these are new entities from an existing entities. This is an existing entity. So why did I do this? This I did to avoid repetition of code. This concept is referred to as inheritance. So Java supports, okay, so Java supports reusability, okay, with a special of code, okay, called as inheritance. So the fields and methods present in a class can be reused by creating new classes for that class. What I did in the previous example, what I did for this entity, I created two new entities, and this allowed me to access, reuse this from any of these two entities. I am now able to access this particular method from any of these entities, child entities. I can access this code. So that's basically reusability. So this reusability feature you can provide in industry. Okay, only if you know this feature, if fortunately or unfortunately, if you all enter a software industry, okay, then you are supposed to make use of this inheritance. Only if you are aware of these, okay, it may be immaterial whether your company asks you to design your code using Java, or your company may ask you to design the code using Python. Okay, you should know about inheritance. Only when you know inheritance, and only when you know the importance of this inheritance, okay, you shall be able to use those features of those programming languages while developing your code. So I hope now you have understood what is inheritance. So what is inheritance? The process of creating new classes, okay, or the derived classes or the subclasses for an existing class or the base class. See, already existing class is called as the super class, or it is called as the base class. This I had called in my example as father. So that is called as the super class or the base class. And for that, there I had created two entities called as son one and son two. Here I am calling them as Y. I am calling that as Y. So Y is called as a derived class or the subclass. So this is the superclass and this is the subclass. What for I need to create superclasses and subclasses? It is for the purpose of avoiding what? Repetition of code. I can use either, I have to use what is called as inheritance. So the newly formed class might have acquired all or few characteristics of the existing class. Say, it is like this. Say, this is your father, okay, and this is you. You would have acquired all the characteristics of your father, or at least some of the characteristics of our parents we will inherit. For example, if suppose say, usually we inherit all bad qualities of our parents. Okay, if say your father has one bad quality, you may have you may have acquired that bad quality, and along with that you might have acquired some new bad quality which was not present in the father. A newly formed class or the derived class, okay, you must observe this, it might have acquired all or few of the characteristics of the existing class. From this parent class, okay, all characteristics may come to Y, or some characteristics may come to Y. Okay, this concept we refer to as inheritance. We have different types of inheritance. You just observe what are the types of inheritance that are available. Okay, the types of inheritance that are available are single level inheritance, wherein we have the father class and the child class, and the family tree stops at this level, at one level only. Okay, a father gets a son and the son doesn't get any children. Okay, his family tree stops at one level, that is single level inheritance. This is multi-level inheritance, that means more than one level. If suppose this is one level, okay, if I go beyond one level, that is, okay, father has a son, son has another son called Z, Z may have another son, this son may have another son, and so on. If it goes beyond one level, then this is called as multi-level inheritance. You should be very careful with the term multi-level, and you have something called as multiple. You should not get confused with multi-level inheritance and multiple inheritance. So they are two different things. So what is multi-level? I have told, if the family tree goes beyond one level, trying to get a new entity from the newly obtained entity. Okay, trying to get a new entity from the newly obtained entity is called as multi-level inheritance. Hierarchical inheritance. You see, there is a father at home, he doesn't have any work. So what can a father without any work can do? Okay, he can get only children. So having more than one child for a single base class, this is a single base class, I have so many children for this base class. No family planning. You should not use the term family planning. So just to make you understand the concept, I am using these terms. Please don't use these terms while writing these examples, while giving your answers. So just to make you understand, I am using these terms. Please excuse me if I am wrong, if I have used these kinds of examples. My intention is to make you understand the concepts. So that's why I give these kinds of examples. What is this? What is this type of inheritance called? This is called as hierarchical inheritance. What do you mean by hierarchical inheritance? Trying to have more than one derived class, okay, for a single base class, okay, is known as hierarchical inheritance. If you tilt this diagram, okay, if you tilt this diagram, I can't give any living examples for this. Please excuse me. Okay, if you tilt this diagram, what you get is multiple inheritance. Okay, trying to derive a single class single entity from more than one base entity. You see, this is one parent, this is parent 2, this is parent 3. Okay. So trying to get a single entity from more than one base entity is called as multiple inheritance. Opposite of this is hierarchical inheritance. Trying to get so many children, a single parent trying to get more than one child is called as hierarchical inheritance. Okay. Trying to derive an entity from more than one base entity is called as multiple inheritance. Okay. So you should know the difference between multiple inheritance and multi-level inheritance. This is multi-level inheritance and this one is multiple inheritance. Combination of more than one type of inheritance. Okay. Combination of more than one type of inheritance is called as hybrid inheritance. You see here, from here till here, you find what is called as hierarchical inheritance. That is, father having too many children. Okay, this is hierarchical inheritance. From here till here, what you find is multiple inheritance. From these three entities B, C, D, we are trying to derive E. So this is multiple inheritance. This portion is hierarchical inheritance. Combination of any two types of inheritances, more than one inheritance, is called as hybrid inheritance. So we saw single level inheritance. Trying to derive one class from another class is called as single level inheritance. Trying to derive more than one level, going beyond one level, is a multi-level inheritance. Trying to create more than one child entity from a single base entity is hierarchical. Reverse of that is multiple. Combination of any two types of inheritances. Here we are showing combination of hierarchical and multiple. It need not be hierarchical and multiple always. It can be a combination of any two types of inheritances. So that is called as multiple.